Prachi on stage. So Prachi, you've come a long way. It's right from your Indian netball team. A lot of names have been given to you, like the Queen of the Court and through Punjabi serials. And then now with megastar Mammootty, what is the story?
So acting happened to me in 2016 when I started with my first show on Star Plus named as Diyor Baati Hum. So acting was never planned. I never aspired to become an actor. It was an opportunity given to me. And I thought that I'm fortunate enough to get this beautiful chance to try something new in life. And that's how I took a risk, left everything in Delhi, whatever I was doing, and then thought of starting a new life, a new career, and that's how acting happened. And Mamangam happened to me last year while I was doing my show, second show for Star Plus named as Ikyavan, and they were looking for, Vivek messaged me saying that, you know, we need a girl like you who can dance and who can, you know, do action sequences and somebody who is a decent actor with a little background and with a little experience. So that's how my name came into reference, and I was auditioned for it and was shortlisted, and this beautiful character Onimaya happened to me, and it has been a long journey of 2 years, but finally we're coming to this result. I mean, you know, our baby is going to get, you know, released on 12th of December, and I'm really excited about it.
Thank you so much. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. All right, may I give it up, ladies and gentlemen. He's responsible for a lot of films, right from Slumdog Millionaire, Mission Impossible, Ghost Protocol, you name it. He has been doing action for that long. Sir, can you just explain, tell us about Kalaripayattu and how it is the world's most oldest martial art?
Sabse pehle to main ek baar bata deta hun ki I am not new to Malayalam cinema. 30 years ago, जब मैंने पहले दिन एज एन एक्शन डायरेक्टर काम किया था, इट वॉज फॉर ए मलयालम फिल्म. और जो मैंने एज एन इंडिपेंडेंट एक्शन डायरेक्टर स्टार्ट कैमरा एक्शन बोला था, मलयालम फिल्म के लिए बोला था, और मैं पहले भी एहसानमंद था, हमेशा जिंदगी भर एहसानमंद रहूँगा मलयालम सिनेमा का, मलयालम सिनेमा से जुड़े लोगों का, कि जिन्होंने मेरे पे फेथ किया और मेरे को ब्रेक दिया. और कलरी के बारे में, क्योंकि मैं शुरू से जब भी एक्शन डायरेक्टर बना तो मेरा जुड़ना रहा मलयालम सिनेमा से जुड़ना रहा, तो कलरी इट इज़ सच ए मार्शल आर्ट के इसके साथ भी जुड़ा रहना पड़ा. और ज़्यादा एक्सपोजर मेरे को मिला जब मैं 2001 में अशोका की शूटिंग कर रहा था. उसके डायरेक्टर थे मिस्टर संतोष सिवन, जो केरला से हैं, डीओपी भी वही थे. तो उसमें बहुत सारे जो कलरी आर्टिस्ट थे, फाइटर्स थे, केरला से मंगा के हमने सभी एक्शंस में यूज़ किए, और वो जो आर्ट फॉर्म देख के आई जस्ट फेल इन लव विद दिस आर्ट. इट इज़ सो ब्यूटीफुल, सो पोएटिक, क्योंकि आप भी स्क्रीन पे देखो जैसे जो कलरी परफॉर्म करते हैं, इट इज़ समथिंग ए मिक्स ऑफ डांस एंड फाइटिंग स्पिरिट. तो जो उसमें मूवमेंट्स हैं आप देखो, नहीं तो कुछ नहीं, जैसा बॉडी रोटेट करते हैं, घूमते जैसे भी, तो उसी हिसाब से वहाँ से एक्सपोजर मिला. वहाँ से जहाँ जहाँ मेरे को मौका मिला मैं इस आर्ट को यूज़ करता रहा. और फिर 2010 में मैंने मरिंदर तम जी की फिल्म की थी रावण, उसमें बहुत सारी कलरी फाइट यूज़ किया. लेकिन हमेशा, क्योंकि कभी भी हम लोग ऐसी आर्ट यूज़ करते हैं जो ऑलवेज नीड ए एक्सपर्ट, तो पिछले 20 साल से मिस्टर सुनील है जहाँ पे, जो कलरी का वहाँ पे ही इज़ मिस्टर सुनील, जो वहाँ पे कलरी का स्कूल चलाते हैं. और जब भी मेरे को जरूरत पड़ती है आई कॉल हिम टू गाइड मी, टू शो मी, एंड ही ऑलवेज ट्रेन्स द एक्टर्स एंड गाइड्स मी अबाउट द दिस थिंग. और दूसरा, जब भी हम लोग ऐसी कोई आर्ट फॉर्म की बात करते हैं तो सबसे बड़ी, हम तो सोचते हैं जब उसको विजुलाइज करते हैं, लेकिन जो एक्टर्स हैं वो सिनेमा उसको लोगों तक लेके जाते हैं. एंड हैट्स ऑफ टू मामूटी सर, उन्नी एंड अच्युतन, वेयर इज दिस बॉय, जस्ट प्लीज, एंड हैट्स ऑफ टू देम फॉर ब्रिंगिंग इट टू द स्क्रीन सो कन्विंसिंगली, सो कन्विंसिंगली. तो क्रेडिट गोज टू देम.
थैंक यू सो मच सर, प्लीज हैव अ सीट. थैंक यू. जोर से और तालियां हो सकती है गाइस. थैंक यू. नाउ इट्स यू Achyutan, please, please, please come on stage. He's a star in the making. इस बंदे को ये फिल्म इसलिए मिली क्योंकि इन्होंने ट्रेन किया बहुत एक्सेसिवली और ये पहले से कलरी करते हैं, उसकी वजह से ही लैंडेड अप इन दिस रोल. सो टेल मी अच्युतन, हाउ आर यू डूइंग, हाउ आर यू फीलिंग because it is Mammootty sir and so many other artists, and you have achieved something very impossible. So how are you feeling right now?
I'm so excited right now. And I came to Mamanga movie through an audition which was held in my Kalari. I've been studying Kalari from my fifth age. And this is my story.
Lovely. All right. So how is it working with Mammootty sir?
It was a great experience working with the legend in acting. And sir has given me a lot of advices for my acting. It's my first time and I was a little tensed. So sir told me to be confident and free while acting. Sir is such good person, which I have seen in my whole life.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. All right, one more question. How hard do you train and how many hours in a day do you train to achieve such a level of finesse?
I practiced Kalari daily 2 hours, and Saturday and Sunday evening time maximum 4 hours. And from the Kalari which I am studying now, it's a little different in the film, and I have studied Sword and Urumi for the film.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Please have a seat. All right. This other person's nickname is Muscle Alia. Can I please have Undi on stage? Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, this one lovely question to you. Do you think that, do you believe that action is the only genre that can cut across boundaries? What do you feel?
Good evening, everyone. I do feel that action as a mode can cut across barriers, because you know, action is something we relate to entertainment. Cinema is all about entertainment, is what I feel. And action doesn't have a language barrier as such. So it does help. But proper content is much more important. You cannot sell action with a lot of dishum and stuff. You need a proper content. You need an emotional balance to it. So with Mamangam, we have tried to do that. Mamangam as a movie is not about just the war sequences. It handles with the it's about the emotions that lead towards the war and the situation and circumstances. I'm just glad that being a hardcore fan of Mammooka and someone who started his career with him. To get an opportunity to be a part of the movie which represents Malayalam industry on a national level in such a... So this movie, it wouldn't have been possible without Mammooka. The reason is because the cost is... when you do a Malayalam film, we do face a certain cost issues. But then when you have a star who can be the face of the nation, we can sell the product with him. So that's when the product can visualize, and our producer, the director, the opportunity to work with Shyam Kaushal sir, knowing the fact that I'm a huge fan of action, and Mamangam as a project really gave me that opportunity, and with Mammooka we could bring the movie here. We have tried our best to make sure that the emotion is communicated properly through the language. So then we have dubbed the movie in Hindi. I have tried my best to render my lines in Hindi. So the movie should not lose its soul in translation. So there has been a genuine effort to make sure the movie is enjoyable to the entire nation. And Mamangam, though happened at one part of Kerala, I don't think it should be restricted that way. It's a part of India, and the whole of the nation should know what happened, how did it happen, and yeah, some things like that.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. You. Now may I please request Inya to come up on stage. Thank you so much. Please give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Yeah, hi. Please have a seat. I'll just stand here.
So, Namaskara, Mumbai.
Yeah, so tell me about your character and working with the star cast. How was it? It's Mammootty, it's him, it's Achyutan, it's everybody. So how was it? And the director.
Tensed actually, because in Mumbai, it's my first press meet. For a historical movie, and I'm so excited and happy also. Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to say something more? Add anything else?
Yes, of course. Mamangam mere ko bahut special movie hai ki ye char bhashaon mein release ho rahi hai, और मम्मूटी सर के साथ मेरा तीसरी बार वर्क करती हूँ. पहला जो मूवी पारोल और पुत्तन पनम, तीसरा मूवी है मामांगम. सो मम्मूटी सर, वर्किंग विद मम्मूटी सर इज़ ऑलवेज अमेजिंग एंड इट्स लाइक अ ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस ऑल्सो. एंड आई थिंक लाइक मामांगम क्रू इज़ अ वेरी 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 experienced crew because we got like lot of people who work in different field is very very expertise. So I think that I'm lucky to be a part of Mamangam. And maine mere character ka naam tha Unni Neeli. Unni Neeli ek devadasi kind of character hai. Ye character ke liye main bahut mehnat karti hu. I speak little bit of Hindi, okay? Please don't mind if it is a mistake.
Come on, we can encourage you. Come on, we can do this.
जो character के लिए मैं बहुत मेहनत कर दिया क्योंकि एक character देवदासी kind of typical traditional girl है and it's an acting oriented character too. I put lot of effort like a strict diet and like workout and contouring my body to make that character appearance fit on me. And I put lot of effort for this because in Malayalam industry we need like lot of like a plumpy look and like chubby wala. So I have to become trim for this character particularly. And I'm basically a classical dancer, so I had a lovely song to perform in this movie called the Boondon Si song as well, and it's choreographed by Brinda Master. I'm very happy once again that to be a part of Mamangam because it's not that easy to make one movie in four languages. That too from Malayalam industry, like we make like more realistic movies and all, and coming into other states like more of colorful and fantasy and all. In Bollywood also they love to watch a lot of colorful sequences, but in Telugu also we used to see a lot of movies which comes with a lot of action, is very dramatic and like artificial with a lot of graphics and all. But in this Mamangam movie, we shot a lot of sequences with realistic effect. That's what director said, that we had a very big grand set, like 2 to 3 sets we had. And for my character, Unni Neeli, it is a typical palace kind of set. We shot in Cochin, and the grand set for the war also, we had a 12-acre set. And I think the making you people already saw. And yeah, this movie is going to release on December 12th, and I'm looking forward for the success of Mamangam. Yeah, thank you.
Give it up. Thank you so much. Now, please, can I call on stage Mr. Shankar Ramakrishnan to please come on stage? Sir, please educate us about the world of Mamangam, and you know, and the warriors who fought in it.
Good evening, friends. Good evening, Bombay. Much has been spoken. I think the rest you have to watch on screen on December 12th. We have nothing more to say because film is all about action, and Shri M. Padmakumar has done a epic work behind the screen to make this epic work on screen. So this film is about unsung heroes, and unsung hero is slowly becoming a cliche because everybody of us has a hero within us. Here we have an umbilical cord relationship with the Hindi film industry because most of the small films which we make in our language get bloated up and become big productions in Hindi film, and we watch and gape. Like our small ideas could make it big in the Hindi film industry. So here is one film that you cannot remake. That is what Mr. Mammootty makes a big point, because his film is very special. He has been a legendary actor, you all know, but then he's a legendary visionary for me, a film student, because for the last many years where I've been watching him with admiration, he has been doing things which are very unique. So this is a film with a unique story, and this is a story that will stand for centuries to come. And I would like to call 3 more people who are among the audience, like they are the unsung heroes that the team Mr. M. Padmakumar is leading. We don't have Manoj Pillai, the DOP, or Raja Mohammed, the editor, or Mani, the Mohandas, the art director, but we do have Ullas Krishna, there he has been working as in the direction department, Mr. Siraj Kalla, and also Meera Talakotur. She has been working in the production department to make this, because their sleeplessness is all about this film hitting the screens on December 12th. There are a lot of people who are still toiling, and some of us are sharing the stage under his leadership. But we have to make a point that this is a rare opportunity, because it's the first film which is going to have such a vast audience on the first day, that no film from our region has done this before. So whenever I have a small conversation with Mamuga regarding this, he asserts that a history is made not just by making a film, but the way it is, you know, like coming out of the box and presented it to you. Everybody gets a mic to speak, and I think the biggest statement will be made when the film comes on screen. Thank you.
So there is one more question which I'd like to ask. Could you actually tell us the layers of characterization? That's very important. So if you can just put a little more light on it.
The film in the posters or in the trailer that you have been seeing is primarily about a warrior class and the rivalry between a neighboring kingdom and this particular region from which these warrior clans come from. So we are used to watching Chinese films where divided kingdoms fight for power. But here, basically, this festival, the word Mamangam represents a festival, a trade festival. And this trade festival, which happens once in 12 years, did not represent just commerce, but it was also the symbol of power. So this one clan of Zamorins who undertook the mastering this festival, or becoming the master of this festival, was challenged by warriors from across the river. So they came up from four different families, led by either one of the masters from those galleries. So these people who come from these particular families also had the support of the local people, including members from all the religions and also the poor people. And they would come and challenge the master. I'm just telling you the premise of the story. You have to watch the film. The film has a more than the prima facie slew of characters that it has, it also represents a very strong sense of womanhood, because these warriors are actually sent by women who are much more braver than these warriors, because they don't consider these people as dead. They still continue to wear their ornaments, or they don't change their lifestyle because their son or their husband or their brother goes to the war. So this is also about those women who actually garnered revenge within their womb and also made this war last for centuries in the name of their blood feud. That's it.
Thank you so much. Now, may I please request Mr. Mammootty to come on stage? And please. Everybody, give it up, ladies and gentlemen. All right.
First of all, congratulations to the team Mamangam. This is Simran Singh here. So my question is to you, sir. Mammootty sir, here in the center. Congratulations to you and the team. The film looks fantabulous. It's very fantastic. So my first question to you is, since it's an untold story, a story that we don't know, we have to witness the epic. Tell us about the germ of this idea. When did you thought, you know, we should make a film which should tell the untold story of this epic history?
This is not actually untold. has
but we are but part of the
not,
India is
not
unknown.
Told on screen.
Ji.
Just written about this story many times and many people okay. in many ways. Ji. So if you go through the history or you read these books, you will just definitely get inspired to make a film out of it. You can make not only one film, you can make minimum 10 to 15 films out of it. Such a big, vast history, a vast, vast incident about it. So we can take one, we will make, we might make one more sometime. Depends. About, see, the it happened for 3 centuries, so you can imagine.
Thank you, sir.
Amoka, this is Jyoti Venkatesh from Bombay.
Hello, how are you, Jyoti?
Fine. This is not the first time that you have acted in a genre like this. Several Malayalam films you have acted like this. But what was the biggest challenge when you set out to act in a film like this, as opposed to a social film?
Yeah, the two films were, one is Parsi Raja, that is a, a story about a king who fought against the British, and that is more about patriotism. And Madakan Veeragatha, again, it's a folklore drama, that is again a folklore. This is again more older, maybe, older history, 15th to 18th century it happened, and there are not many stories. Of course, the character, both all are different. That really attracted me.
But as an actor, what kind of challenges you face when you do a film like this?
Actor is always facing challenges, Jyoti. They are always challenged.
And one more question is that not many here may be aware of the fact that you started your career as a criminal lawyer.
Lawyer, not a criminal.
So, do you miss?
I don't miss, but I still am aware of what is happening around me. I miss it, but still because I preferred to be an actor. That's why I came here. So I should not miss it.
Long back, we saw you in a Hindi film called.
See, there are so many other people.
Dharti Putra.
Dharti Putra, of course.
That,
he did not mention about Dharti Putra. He was the fight master there. The second or third film, maybe.
It was in
96.
After that, why we are not seeing you in straight Hindi film?
Many reasons for that. That we'll discuss later.
Just a minute. May I please call the executive producer of the film, Mr. Vivek? Please come on stage. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
See, incidentally, there are two more big great actors who have participated in our film. They are sitting in front of the. See, I don't know. Can you manage them also some seat? They will. You can ask something to them
Sudev.
Also.
Sudev,
mistress. They are enjoying beer being.
Tarun Arora.
Small part of this film. I was actually enjoying the view from down there. A little upset to be brought up here, but thank you. Thank you, thank you, sir.
He's a celebrated actor. He is a Film Institute guy. He has been awarded as the best actor two years ago. Malayalam Films, best actor. Not really small, but a big guy.
Hello. Mamuti, sir.
Yes.
इस फिल्म को बनाने में पूरा कितना समय लगा आपको?
We took almost 2 years. We shot nearly 120 days, maybe 142 days.
Mamuti sir, and to the other cast. Sir, my question to you is: we are living in this age where you know there are no more boundaries here. Now there are no more boundaries here. The language boundary is not here. Bollywood actors going in regional films are coming in here in Bollywood. So now we are having this example of Mamangam as well, right from Bahubali to 2.0 to Mamangam. So what do you want to say about this trend, the change of trend?
Of course, we are getting united again, more strong.
Yeah, please sir, continue sir, please. And to the other cast member, if they can please add what's their input about it.
So the boundaries are getting blurred and being a North Indian, I never knew you know what the culture of Malayalam industry is, and I'm fortunate to be starting my debut with a beautiful industry which is so content oriented, and obviously to be launched opposite Mamuka, and
you're opposite me.
I'm next to you right now. So it was a wonderful experience, and you know, moving forward, it is going to be called as Indian cinema rather than Bollywood, Tollywood, Mollywood, Punjabi industry. So I think, yeah. And audience is also becoming very, very smart. I think the main hero of the film is the content, and that's the beauty about it.
Can you guys please share about that? What do you want to say about the change in the trend?
Actually, I believe the advent of the internet and the accessibility of online data has really made all kinds of content accessible, and now we don't really wonder or worry about the language or the grammar of the content as far as the content itself is effective. And if the story is good, stories are universal. And they do transcend languages. And now, because of technology, this has been aided more and more, and we are only going to get more and more seamless.
I would like to share. तो उसमें एक लाइन थी जिसको ब्रैकेट में लिखा गया था कि आई एम ए पंजाबी मतलब फर्स्ट जनरेशन इन मुंबई कमिंग फ्रॉम ए विलेज इन पंजाब. तो उसमें लिखा था ए पंजाबी डूइंग एक्शन फॉर मलयालम फिल्म्स एंड ब्रैकेट में दिस इज एग्जांपल ऑफ नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन.
वो एब्सोल्युटली
राइट. मे आई फील दिस क्वेश्चन टू मिस्टर विवेक हियर. राइट, मामंगम हैज बीन पेग्ड एज द मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव मलयालम फिल्म. यू नो, यू वांट टू टॉक समथिंग मोर ऑन दैट?
या, इट इज the most expensive Malayalam film to date. See, Malayalam being a very small industry compared to even the bigger industries down south like Tamil and Telugu. Yesterday, we were in Hyderabad, so I was just telling, you know, the budget of even this film is the salary of an actor in Telugu, and or probably lesser than that in Hindi. But yeah, the person I think we all owe this to is a person who is not here, who I really personally miss, because Mr. Venu Kunnapalli, he's a businessman from Dubai. So he's the one who has produced this film, you know, and the vision to do that from an industry like from Malayalam, a small industry where you're not assured of, you know, getting the money back, is a very difficult thing to do. See, Telugu has a huge market. So Bahubali doesn't need the entire country to get back the money. You can get it back from Telugu itself, but Malayalam is not like that. Even overseas, we have a market which is only a bit in the Middle East. But this film is going far wider than that. It's going into countries which has never, you know, seen a Malayalam film being released. So that is happening, yes.
That is only the producer's view. He's only marketing the film. That our films will collect in Kerala. We are sufficient for the last 38 years, I am there.
And the vision behind releasing the film in different languages?
No, that was what Mamukka said. You know, Mamukka had this vision that a film like this, which deals with true history of land, should be seen across the country. Because otherwise, if we make
simple reason is we are not that selfish that we only see the film, we will not allow others to see it.
And a Malayalam film, if it is made only in Malayalam, only Kerala will see the history. So Kerala's history is also India's history, is what he said. I remember him saying that. So, you know, so if it is made into more languages, there are more chances of, you know, the cinema unifying us as a country. So I think that is a great thing. That's the reason why we wanted to make it. You know, the other markets, as I said, you know, it's since it is, it's not a fantasy film. It's rooted in a culture and a time zone. We had to be true to that time zone. So the costumes, everything is Malayalam, but then the emotions are not. You know, so that's
he's our marketing person, and that is why he's marketing.
But why only three South Indian languages? Why not in Kannada?
Kannada people knows other languages too. There was a issue that they won't let other languages to be dubbed now. No. There is. Now it is free. Before we started this. And we are more open. We have no secrets. We will show whatever history we have to others. We don't hide anything. We have nothing to hide.
Sir, and it's not easy, sir. It's good to dream, but it's very difficult making a film in four different languages, which has never been done before in Malayalam. you know, we were in Chennai day before yesterday, we were in Hyderabad. This itself is, you know, not easy to do. But yeah, we're chasing a dream. So.
Hi, this is Shweta from Filmy Beat. Can you hear me? Shweta from Filmy Beat. Congratulations to the team. It's a great trailer. To the director, actually, I'm really curious about the little boy and how you found him and, you know, his role. Can you help us with it? Some more information. With Achyutan, right? Yeah.
Achyutan.
So he's done, as we could see from the making, he's really impressive.
Actually, there was we were searching for a boy like him, who knows martial arts and he has to perform well. He has to do many scenes, emotional scenes and all. We searched many galleries and schools in Kerala and in Kottayam, Puthupalli.
In Kerala,
he's in
from Kottayam.
Kottayam district, Puthupalli is native.
Yeah, he already told us that you've been learning Kalari Payattu since the age of 5.
Yeah.
Okay, and how is your...
There are galleries there all over Kerala.
All over?
Still there, like schools.
Okay.
See, in the evening and morning, they can go and learn there. There is a Kalari in... There is a Kalari near his house. He went there in the morning and he has practiced there.
Okay.
Even during shooting, we were running a Kalari. Kalari means a school.
Okay.
Kalari, piety is the fight. Kalari actually means school.
Okay.
So even we were conducting a school during the shoot. Everybody was fighting there.
Well, that
so there's a subsidiary. Part of the set was converted into a Kalari and we were practicing. You can see that making.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Komal from Indian Express. Mammootty sir, I have a question for you. It's great to have you back in Mumbai after so many years. We recently also met your son Dulkar, who's doing Hindi films. First, I want to know what kind of feedback have you given to his films, and have he has given to Mamangam?
He has nothing to do with that. He does films. That is the children, no. I don't think he was not supposed to communicate or any, but actually I didn't get your question.
Yeah, my question is, since, because we are more familiar to Dulkar, we've interviewed
my
him.
My son.
Yeah, of course. So I'm asking you, have you seen his Hindi films and what kind of feedback if you've given
okay,
him?
Okay, I have seen his films, but we are talking about some other film.
Okay. Okay. So, I have a question related
to... He has not seen, even I have not seen the film yet.
I have a question related to Mamangam. Maybe the producer can answer. It is about, you know, halfway through filming, the director of the film was changed. Why was that done? And how much of that have you retained in the film that has been directed by sir?
I can tell you in one line that it was done in the interest of the film. Nobody does it happily. It is not a pleasant thing to do. So we were left with no option but to take that step. You know, he went to court and, you know, couple of courts upheld whatever we did was right, you know, including Kerala High Court. So I think that's been an unpleasant experience. We have not retained anything from what was shot. It's a completely new film. So I think now we've censored the Malayalam film, the Telugu version has censored the two language of censoring it. I think we're now getting into a phase where, you know, that is behind us and we're looking positively to the future. That's it, yeah.
Hi, Mavudi sir, First of all, congratulations, काफी जबरदस्त ट्रेलर है और इस तरह की फिल्मों का जब ट्रेलर आता है तो हमें इंडियन सिनेमा पर काफ़ी प्राउड होता है सर अगर बात की जाए साउथ इंडियन सिनेमा की तो ऐसी सी फिल्में आती हैं जो कि काफ़ी इम्पैक्टफुल होती हैं पूरा देश ग्लोबली जाती है बट बॉलीवुड में भी जिस तरह बॉलीवुड को भी आप फॉलो करते होंगे कहीं ना कहीं ये आपको कमी नज़र आती है कि उस लेवल की फिल्में नहीं बनाई जाती या बॉलीवुड फिल्म मेकर उस तरह का रिस्क नहीं लेना चाहते जिस तरह का रिस्क साउथ इंडियन मेकर्स लेते हैं
फिल्म मेकिंग इटसेल्फ इज अ रिस्क for the producer. So this is all trials. We cannot stop filmmaking. There are movies are failing and succeeding. So that cannot be the criteria for making films. There are films running. There are good films and bad films are being made. So let's make it and let it be good or bad. That's what our idea is about. And we were confident about subject and we were confident about the movie. So we made it. We were very sincere and we were very frank about it.
Thank you, sir.
We cannot say that some films are failing, so that the film industry will not survive otherwise.
Maul sir, ek saath mein aur ek question hai. Aap ek bahut hi pura desh aapko pyar karta hai aur aap bhi jis tarah desh mein halaat hain aaj jis tarah baatein chal rahi hain, ek south mein bhi ek case hua, north mein bhi ek case hua rape ko lekar ek ladki ke,
so society should be conscious about it. They should change their conscience. They should ask their conscience, what are we and why are we doing like this. So all are about, everybody is concerned about it. What is happening to us? Me too.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Hi, sir. My name is Deepak. I'm a pure Malayali. I'm a huge fan of yours. Sir, so you make from 5 to 8 movies in a year, I think. And this movie itself took you almost 2 years. Okay. My dad is just a 54-year-old guy. He walks 10 minutes, he gets tired. And I see you doing all these stunts and running and you do all these horse rides. And all. How do you get this energy even at this age? Yeah, I'm so surprised. I'm a huge fan of yours. Could you please explain to me?
You are my energy.
All right, one more question, please. Last question.
Hi, my name is Jigar. Hi, my question is to Unni and the other cast members also. How long did you guys take to learn Payattu, if at all you had to kind of do all the stunts? And to the director, if you can tell a little about the music of the film as well. I mean, I understand that's also an important aspect of the film. So if you can just share some light about
it. Did you ask me about the stunts?
Yeah, about the stunts and the preparation for your...
The prep part with the stunts is totally handled by Shyam Koshla, sir. I just have to... I am personally a big fan of action movies. I enjoy watching them. I enjoy doing it. So the easier part for me was when it is handled by Shyam Koshla, sir. I just have to do it correctly. The way he says it, just do it. If I don't do it, I injure myself. But the fact is that I came out uninjured. And that's the best part. It looks quite horrifying with all the swords and all the elephants around, and too much of commotion. We had like thousands of junior artists performing the same Kalaripayattu. It's a difficult art. I'm not a trained Kalaripayattu artist, so it was difficult for me. But then with the proper guidance, I could make sure that I just wanted to make sure that it looks as real as possible on screen. So yeah, the effort was neat, but then I'm pretty happy that it came out for a project which will be showcased across India. So as an actor also, all the little effort that I've taken in will come out good, yeah. So.
See, with the most of the fights were shot in the night. We were shooting nearly 50 to 60 nights together. Night shooting and day?
Main ek bata deta hun aapko, jab ye night shoot chalu hui, to sab ne mere ko bola tha, कि मम्मूटी सर का एक प्रिंसिपल है 11 बजे के बाद में शूट नहीं करते हैं और ये सिटिंग नेक्स्ट टू मी हमने 2 बजे से पहले कभी इनका पैकअप नहीं किया है तो मतलब अमेजिंग एंड जस्ट हैट्स ऑफ टू हिम कभी भी मेरे को ये नहीं सोचना जैसा आपने बोला कि मैं जो विजुलाइज करते समय के ही जब भी बिगनिंग शुरू की तो थोड़ा सा आई वॉज बिट हेजिडेंट तो मैं इनको जाके एक छोटा सा स्टंट था फिर जाके मैंने मम्मूटी सर ऐसा कुछ ऐसा करें तो ऐसा करें ही जस्ट ओपनड अप Master, you do anything. He showed me something, some video. I can do like this. Then I went wild in thinking.
I was promoting myself with him.
So it was a great experience. And Unni, this child, amazing, amazing. I can't explain what they have generated on the screen, but you just see it.
Sir, but is there a specific reason why it was shot only in the night consciously? A technical reason?
It happened in the night.
Okay.
Historically, that thing happened
story
in the night.
That.
Okay. And can you share a little about the music of the film as well? Because that is also...
About music, there is 4 songs in this movie. M. Jayachandran is the music director. And Rafiq Ahmad, Ajay Gopal is the lyrics.
BGM Bapata.
And Sanjeet Balhara is the background score given. He is doing first time in Malayalam, Sanjeet Balhara.
Sanjeet and Ankit.
Our audiographer is Satish.
PM Satish and Manoj Goswami.
Satish and Manoj Goswami.
Ken is the colorist.
Mr. Arora, could you please share your experience of Mamangam?
Hi, good evening, everyone. My name is Tarun Raj Arora. Well, I would like to thank my lucky stars to get a debut, such an epic project. And when I got this offer, I didn't know this movie is going to be so big. My only interest was to work with Mamuka. And that's how I went and signed this movie. It's been a big bucket list to work with such a legend. And the more and more I got involved with the film, I realized that it was really a very, very big film. And I get to work with such talent, from my co-stars to my director, from the action director. And I am wishing that everybody gets to watch this film. I do play a very important but a small role. And I consider myself, again, very lucky to play a small role, but a very, very effective role on such a big film. Thank you, everyone.